Australians understand and they support the need to take action on climate change. So do I. So does our government. I know this because Australians and our government are already taking action on climate change. And we're already delivering. We're already down the path. Australia has already achieved more than a 20% reduction in our emissions since 2005. Australia has already achieved the highest rate of rooftop solar in the world. Australia has already has a rate of installation of renewable energy that is 8 times per capita faster than New Zealand and Japan, and 3 times faster than the United States and the EU and Germany specifically. Australia has already met and beat our Kyoto 2020 targets. And indeed, Australia will beat and meet our 2030 targets as well. Australians' actions on climate change speak louder than the words of others. We're getting it done on emissions reduction. That is the Australian way. And we've done this at the same time as increasing the size of our economy by 45%, growing our economy and creating some 3 million jobs, expanding our exports, expanding our agriculture and resource sectors, in particular our LNG sector. And most recently, Australia now has 1 million of our number back in manufacturing jobs. 1 million Australians employed in manufacturing. This is what is being achieved in Australia. Emissions coming down, our economy growing, and the opportunities of Australians expanding. Australians want action on climate change. They're taking action on climate change, but they also want to protect their jobs and their livelihoods. They also want to keep the cost of living down, and they also want to protect the Australian way of life, especially in rural and regional areas. The Australian way of life is unique. I mentioned this to our party room this morning. After the terrible floods in North Queensland, when I stood in the town hall in Julia Creek, I said we needed to rebuild the cattle industry, which had been devastated in the space of about 24 to 48 hours, for many reasons. But one was because it was part of the unique Australian way of life. And that remains true in all of the challenges we face. Australians want a plan that gets the balance right. And our plan to reach what will be our new official target of reaching net zero emissions by 2050, our plan gets the balance right. Our plan charts a uniquely Australian way that recognises the challenges. The world is changing, and the world's response to climate change is changing the world. It is changing the global economy. This is real. It's happening. We understand it and we recognise it. We need to protect against the threats that come from that. And we also need to realise the opportunities that indeed help mitigate those threats and enable Australia to succeed. We know we can't let the changes that are happening around the world just happen to Australia. We know we can't pretend it's not happening, and the changes that are occurring around the world, just as we haven't been pretending in the actions that both the government has been taking and, most importantly, Australians have been taking. Our plan is a fair plan. It's a practical plan. It's a responsible plan. Our plan for net zero by 2050 is the plan that I believe Australians want, because it gets it right. It's been carefully put together. We've listened very carefully to both the concerns and the ambitions of Australians in pulling this together. to ensure that we get the plan right. Our plan, most importantly, backs Australians to achieve what they want to achieve when it comes to achieving net zero emissions by 2050. Australians want to do that, and our plan enables them to do that. Our plan works with Australians to achieve this goal. Our plan enables them. It doesn't legislate them. It doesn't mandate them. It doesn't force them. It respects them. It understands that Australians want to do this, that they want to improve their pasture, that they want to protect their industries, that they want to see them succeed in the future, that they want to have the skills in the future and for their kids to have the skills in the future to be successful in the world that they will face over the next 30 years. It's a plan that backs Australians. It's also a plan, as I said, that's uniquely Australian. It's an energy, trade and economic plan, not just an environmental plan. It's about delivering results through technology, not taxes. It's focused on Australia's national interests and securing our strengths by determining our own destiny. Australians will set our own path to net zero by 2050, and we'll set it here, by Australians, for Australians. It keeps traditional advantages in the regions while supporting the growth of new industries, and it guarantees we keep downward pressure on those costs of living. It's a plan that ensures that there are many things we don't do as well. It's not a plan at any cost. There's no blank checks here. It will not shut down our coal or gas production or exports. It will not impact households, businesses or the broader economy with new costs or taxes imposed by the initiatives that we are undertaking. It will not cost jobs, not in farming, mining or gas, because what we're doing in this plan is positive things, enabling things. It will not increase energy bills. It is not a revolution, but a careful evolution to take advantage of changes in our markets. And it's not a set and forget plan. It has an insurance policy review mechanism to make sure that it keeps delivering for regional Australia. In this plan, there is accountability. And we will be having the Productivity Commission every 5 years, the first one due by the end of 2023. That will monitor the impact, the socio-economic impact of our plans into the future. So I can say to rural and regional Australians that this is a good plan for you, it's a good plan for all Australians, and we're confident in it, that it is going to secure your future, that you can plan for your future with confidence. And we're backing that up by ensuring that we'll measure that. We won't just be measuring the fact that we'll be reducing emissions, we'll be measuring the fact that we're creating jobs, we'll be measuring the fact that we're boosting incomes, we'll be measuring the fact that we are preserving Australians' livelihoods right across the country, because that is also one of the key measures of performance and success with this plan. So I'll be taking this plan to COP26 for our target to achieve net zero by 2050. It will be supported by our updated projection that will see us exceed our 2030 target with emissions reduction of up to 35% by 2030. We will keep our commitment, though, when it comes to our pledge that we made and took to the last election of 26 to 28%. But we will meet it and we will beat it. And we will beat it with emissions reductions, we believe, of up to 35%. And we may even achieve better. But this is the approach that we put to the Australian people. We said, there's the mark, but we can meet it and we can beat it. And we will. And the world will be able to see us achieving that, and they'll be able to take record of that. Because what Australians are doing now is getting results, and they're going to keep getting results, and they're going to keep getting better results. So we will honour our commitment to the Australian people. That's what I took to them. That's what they approved, and that's what we're doing. And we will continue to work to do even better as part of our plan.